sing, but I can't speak. I'm paralyzed when you're next to me, running on dreams, 'cause I can't see how this could be reality. You're holding me close, but I don't know. Do I let you in? Do I let it show all of my fears?
All right, here we go with Morning Coffee with Rick Alexander. If you remember way back, I was going to do 90 of these and see how it went. And how it went is that January is our biggest month of all-time listenership, and the feedback's been incredible, so we're going to keep doing it. I actually really love this stuff. I really like the long-form interviews as well, because I feel like there's always so many things we can learn from other people that are performing at a high level, and so I think those will always continue as they make sense. But also I really love these because they allow me to share messages and small insights from things that I'm writing in my book, things that I've learned just from professional personal development, and then also things that I've gleaned from other guests. And I'm just kind of going back through all of the past guests now, and I'm trying to figure out exactly what that looks like. And I'm actually just going through all of the past guests now to figure out what lessons we might be missing that I can sort of resurrect and make sense for the listenership. So anyway, I just want to say 90 episodes, well over 90 down, heading into episode 100 of the Morning Coffees, and it's still my favorite thing to do, so the show will go on. All right, today I want to tell you something that is pretty simple, but we have a hard time when it comes to the application of said simplicity, and that is you need to allow yourself to love the things that you love and to pursue them. Now, do you have to pursue them with reckless abandon? Well, maybe. I would say you should. But at the end of the day, I just think if you can start pursuing the things you love, that's going to be a step in the right direction. The way that it works out, the world is always sort of telling us what we should do. And I talk about this a lot on here, but the people that we should date and the things that we should do, they seem to be preordained for us in a lot of ways. And, you know, as we're growing up in our formative years and we're trying to figure out how to fit in, one of the surviving coping mechanisms that we come up with is to be gray. You know, when I look back in training, especially in the special operations community, you know, one of the things people always say is like, oh, you want to be the gray man when you're going through training. Like, you want to blend in. You don't want to get too much attention because attention could be negative and it could make your life really difficult. And I think that's the exact same message that we feel when we're going through school. It's like, don't stand out too much. Don't get in the way because you might end up attracting attention in a negative way, and that would make your life harder. But the thing is, when you're a kid, you're kind of stuck in that situation. And so you have to do what you have to do in order to survive. And there's not a lot of mobility right or left outside of just trying to get through the day. And when you're an adult, though, that changes, but we hold on to that coping mechanism. And we feel like there are things that are, for example, okay for us to pursue and things that aren't. But the thing is, perhaps you have a business idea and you have, or a project or a thing that you want to do, even a hobby, a creative outlet. Allow yourself to pursue that thing, because there's two reasons for that. One, because perhaps you are going to, and I talk about this a lot, I talked about this in my first book, Burn Your Couch, but perhaps you're going to find other things along the way that you love that do align, do resonate with you. And when you continue to step down those roads, you just never know where they go. And 10 years from now, your life could look so much different simply because you gave yourself permission to pursue the things in life that you wanted to pursue. I think that that is super important, and here's why. We don't understand how a life unlived, how a dream unmanifested, exacts its revenge on our life. Right now we're going through this time where there's lots of low-level sort of dismay and disconnection when we think about our lives. And a lot of people are living great lives, but there seems to be something that they're trying to figure out or wish that they could do different. And I think that low-level dissonance is one of the ways that a life unlived exacts its revenge on us. And, you know, the problem with that, this low-level malaise and disconnection and dissonance, is that if it's allowed to continue, it's going to manifest as something physical. See, psychological issues always manifest in our physiology if they're given long enough. Now, it's super easy to think of examples of that. It sounds kind of woo-woo when you talk about it right off the cuff, but if you really think about examples of that, one of them might be the fact that when you get nervous, you get butterflies in your stomach. Like, what is going on there? A psychological coping mechanism is manifesting in your physiology, and it's kind of fucking your day up. Well, that can happen in many, many different ways. And so sometimes we just have to give ourselves permission to pursue the things, because we're not in high school anymore. We're not in middle school anymore. If there's a bully in your life, cut them the fuck out. Get rid of them. You know, one of the things that happens that I heard recently is, like, when we start to expand and we start to grow, sometimes we have our friends who cut us down. And I heard a really good explanation of that process, and it is this. If you begin to grow in your life and the friends that you have around you are trying to cut you down or not support your growth or your creativity or the direction, those aren't your friends. Those are just people that you know. And that reality can be really harsh. But if somebody legitimately is not excited for your growth and doesn't want that for you, that isn't your friend. Right? That might actually be a bully. And since you're not in high school anymore, cut them the fuck out of your life. And everything will work out much better. But you have to give yourself permission to pursue the things. And here's the thing. By not giving yourself permission to pursue those things because of what you think other people might think, you're actually not helping those other people in any way. You're only hurting yourself. And then you never know, again, like I said, how that life unlived is going to manifest in your life. I don't think it's going to be pretty. It typically never is. So give yourself permission to do the things that you want to do. And it doesn't matter if that's a job or a hobby or a person that you want to pursue. It really doesn't matter, but you have to give yourself permission to start doing the things you want to do so you can start getting out of this life of low-level dissonance and disconnection with the world around you. You don't need permission. You need to start taking steps in the right direction so that you can look around at your life and say that you actually chose it, that you actually love it, and that it's a life that you've chosen to live, that you've chosen to author. Because if you don't, you're going to continue with this sort of life of disconnection and dissonance and not feeling connected to the things around you and not feeling passionate. And you know, the opposite of passion, it's not hate. It's really not. The opposite of passion is apathy. And when you have apathy toward your life, you're not going to pursue it in a way that's going to make you effective. You want to be a game changer. You want to have impact on the people around you and the world at large. You want to have a life that you can say that you actually chose. Then you have to start giving yourself permission to pursue the things that you're in love with. Let them pursue you back. See what that world looks like. Explore what you're in love with. Explore what you're passionate about. And just see where it goes. Be open to the roads that might show themselves. I love you guys. I'll talk to you later on Morning Coffee. Oh, I should give me something right. Oh, just let me in your life. Give me something more. 'Cause I need to score. Oh, now you're doing it right. Oh, I love how you twist that knife. Give me sweat. Around all night, I make you feel good. All night, darling.
too.
All right.
This ain't a game, 'cause I don't wanna fuck around unless you wanna fuck around.
All right.